A 30-year-old woman was brought to the hospital after being stabbed in the left side of her neck, about 2 centimeters superior to the middle of the clavicle. After the bleeding was controlled, she suffered tachypnea, rapid respiration. Physical examination revealed tracheal deviation to the right and poor breath sounds on the left side of her thorax. Which of the following injuries which most likely produce these signs? So these are the injuries here. Tearing of the left brachiocephalic vein. Well, the left brachiocephalic vein could have been torn, but here it is mentioned that in the stem that bleeding was controlled. So tearing of the left brachiocephalic vein will not contribute to these signs and symptoms. Section of the left recurrent laryngeal nerve. The left recurrent laryngeal nerve, again, could have been sectioned here by this stab wound. But sectioning of the left recurrent laryngeal nerve will affect phonation. It might result in difficulty in respiration, especially if it is bilateral, but it will not result into these symptoms. Mainly, it results in hoarseness of voice. Penetration of the cervical pleura. And this is the possibility that is a valid possibility, and we have to remember again the surface landmarks of the lung and the pleura. The lung and the pleura, they extend into the neck about 2 to 4 centimeters above the medial end of the clavicle, and this is what we call the dome of the pleura and the apex of the lung. And therefore, the pleura could have been injured on the left side, and this will result in pneumothorax. Pneumothorax accumulation of air into the pleural cavity, and this will result in the tracheal deviation. It will push the trachea from left side to the right side because the injury was on the left side. And of course, this will compress the lung and will result in poor breath sounds on the left side of the thorax. This will not be associated with bleeding because it is air that is entering into the pleural cavity. And the reason here is that the pleura extends into the neck. Because of the obliquity of the first rib, crushing of the left phrenic nerve, again, this is again a valid option, but the left phrenic nerve will result in difficulty in respiration if it is crushed because of the involvement of the diaphragm. But it will not result in deviation of the trachea, will not result in poor breath sounds, and so on. Tearing of the left subclavian artery, again the left subclavian artery which is related to the first rib, like the left subclavian vein, both of them they can be injured, but the question here mentioned that there is no bleeding. The bleeding was controlled, and then the patient developed these signs and symptoms. So it is penetration of the cervical pleura resulting in left pneumothorax.